Hi everyone, it's Calvin the Destroyer. This video, we need to make everyone aware of COPPA, what that is, and what we as creators need to do about these proposed changes. We also need to talk about the fact that something's missing, something big. But first things first, we need to follow the links in the description below and fill out the petition and send your comments to the FTC. Please be sure not to spam those resources. Write down what you want to say and then reread it and make sure that your point is clear before submitting. That way we can make a better impact. So, YouTube got fined and then passed the fines on to us, the creators. But there is something missing, or someone missing. Someone big. Someone that's a real big player in YouTube's income. That's right. The advertisers. Yes, the companies that pay YouTube to run their ads on YouTube have been left out of this whole you can get sued game, or you can get fined. Many YouTubers have stated that you can only get fined if you are collecting tracking data and collecting information on viewers. Creators do not get to track viewers, nor do we get to see any of this data. The only thing that creators can do is create content and a small amount of ad revenue that you can collect. So I have a feeling that the last thing that YouTube wants to do is throw its advertisers under the bus and then have them take on the burden of large fines. Fines like the FTC's $42,000 per video or whatever it is. It doesn't matter. If it's like $10, it would probably scare people away. So should they get fined? I think they should, because I think so, because anyway you look at it, the advertisers have more control of the tracking data than the creators do. When you pay to run ads on YouTube, you as an advertiser can choose the type of audience that you want to see, that you want to see your ads. I believe you could also choose the demographic and the location, but I haven't had money to spend to advertise on YouTube, so I wasn't able to go that deep into it. But right off the bat, as stated on YouTube's website, it says yes, you can, and you'll select the geographic location where your ads are seen and who sees them based on their age and interest in topics like food or travel. Learn more about how you can reach the right people here, and it has a link to click through more. So, it's really, like, crazy how all this stuff always happens. Instead of, like, running a business, they just set everything on fire and leave all the little people scared. And I've seen it many times before with their April Fools, we're going to vote for the best video on YouTube, and then their step up on the requirements to be monetized. It's like, I'm not monetized. My channel is still too small. Even though I have like 250,000 views and over 500 videos, but it's not what they want. If you look at YouTube, there's a whole bunch of people on there that are just like kids, and if you don't appeal to 12-year-olds or under, your videos never see any traffic, unless you catch wind of that viral thread and you become viral. So, my recommendations is to have YouTube put in that age gate, and then find a way to advertise to the made for kids videos so that people will still have an incentive to make made for kids videos, because the kids are never going to go away. I've been a kid, I've known so many times where we try to get onto sites we're not supposed to be on, and just fun times. We never really got very far, but you need to have that age gate. You just can't leave the door open, and you can't dump the responsibility onto the creators who absolutely have like no control over that. Unless they're gonna give me the keys to YouTube, you can't find me. I'm sorry. It's like I'm not gonna put gas in the car unless Dad gives me the keys to the car. It doesn't work that way. So definitely think that the advertisers should be brought into this, and they should be addressed, because well, they're paying for the ads and YouTube is distributing those ads, and all we're getting is just a small slice of what the ads earn. So the whole system needs a revamp, and I'm hoping that the questions that they're doing for their inquiry is addressing those things. But we won't know until, what is it, the 9th? And by then it might be too late to make any changes. So hopefully that works. If not, be sure to check out my Patreon and come support me there. I can still release videos on my website or anywhere else, really. It's just a matter of YouTube getting our act together. But for supporting me, I have my Patreon. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my videos. Also, feel free to check out all the other videos I have. You might find something that you like. I don't really do these kind of topics. I just really felt that we needed to reach out and get everybody notified and let them know what's going on, because this is actually a really big, big thing. Anytime you start talking money, it's like people can't afford to pay like $10, let alone $42,532. Wouldn't it be funny if they put the amount at the max size for a register? Was it 28,393 or something like that? But anyway, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Definitely check out those links, fill out the petition, and send your comments and concerns to the FTC. And I guess we'll keep our fingers crossed. So hopefully I'll see you later.